Hi friends, in this video we are going to see one of the important concepts in Java memory management, that is how the JVM internally works. Now, what are the different modules involved in it and how the functional starts and how it completes the entire workflow process. What happens when any Java program compiles, it is converted into the dot class files with the help of Java class loader. The class loader system at once it loads all the dot class files, and with the help of identification of various runtime data areas, it can be classified into various categories. Rightly, we have method area, heap area, Java threads, program counter registers, native internal threads. So firstly, runtime data areas, we load method heap area and method areas. So the heap area is mainly responsible for storing class instances and array variables. Method area responsible for storing class structures, constructors, structures, method values that are passed between method executions, and also the interfaces and so on. Now comes the Java threads. As we know that multi-threading is also part of Java programming. So all the multi-threading thread areas are handled by Java threads. Then comes the program counter register. So each JVM instruction has a program counter register associated with it. So non-native JVMs have program counter registers and native JVM are unassigned. Now comes the native internal threads. Here native in the sense, the other than Java languages, what are the languages such as C, C++, what happens with the help of native method libraries? As we know that in C, there is memory management is manual. That is, manually we can allocate and deallocate memory. So memory management is bit different in C and Java. It's totally different. So with the help of native method libraries, there is native method interface, and these native interface interacts with the native internal threads to perform memory management for native type, that is C, C++ kind of code. After that, we have garbage collector. As we know, garbage collector is automatically, garbage collection in Java is automatically performed. So how does it perform automatic garbage collection? How does it identify which object should be automatically garbage collected? So specifically, I'm specifying as object because JVM perform garbage collection only for heap kind of memory. So we have garbage collector identifies dereference object. Dereference in the sense the objects that are no longer needed or not associated with any other active objects. Such objects are automatically identified by JVM, and then it perform deallocation of such objects automatically. Although we may manually also perform, but JVM does not comply strictly. Now comes into picture JIT compiler. JIT compiler comes at runtime. So runtime, what it does is it converts the bytecode into the native machine code. So with the help of the native machine code, it can be executed on various type of architecture, be it Linux, Solaris, Windows, different kind of machine code or different kind of architecture it can be executed. So it comprises of the execution engine. So that was all in the JVM architecture. Thanks for watching the video. Goodbye.